Hey, this is Papa from StreetFighterTradingSystem.com. So, all right, guys. Today, I want to do a video to basically show you how we can put all the lessons that we have learned together and apply it on the market. Right. So, I'm gonna take yesterday's data and walk you through bar by bar what would have been my analysis to find trades, opportunities. Okay, so here I have the chart, so it's the ES1000 tick chart. We are looking, so on the x-axis, you will see that it's the Bangkok time, and in Thailand, basically the market opens at 8:30, okay? So we will check the data only starting from 8:30 onwards, okay? So the market open, the first thing that we want to check, of course, on our checklist is what is the direction of the market, okay? So here we can see that the market is the SMA is flat. So if it's flat, the rule is that it's random and we cannot take trades. So what we want to do is to wait for the market to be either having like an upward SMA or downward SMA. So we can see it's flat, flat, flat. So we cannot do anything here. You just have to stay out of your computer. Then here we start to have the angle with an impulse move to the upside, right? So the angle of the basically the SMA is going up, we see an impulse, right? So what we are trying to do now is to find if this retrace is going to go and bounce from the 21 EMA or not, right? So from the moment it doesn't. So it doesn't, right? So since it doesn't retrace to the 21 EMA, we cannot take this trade, okay? It starts to retrace to the 21 EMA, but look at the candle. The candle is, so since it's going upwards, we are looking to buy. So we will put like our buy stop wanting about this bar, but we cannot do it because this candlestick, right, close on its bottom 25%, and it's not what we want when we want to buy, right? So it's a very bad candle. We cannot take this trade, okay? So it seems to have worked. It seems to have went higher, but still, it's not because it goes higher that it will go higher every time. This is a basically a bad probability scenario. Okay, so what we want to do is to be patient and only wait for all the elements that we know to basically work. Okay, so we go on the next trade again. I went a little bit too far. Okay, so let's say you have seen this. So you have your impulse move. It retraced to the EMA 21. The candle is, I would say, okay, but it's red. Okay, so it's still okay. I would have still put a buy stop above this candle. It is still considered as a good candle. It's like a hammer, but and it closed above its top 25%, right? So let's see if we were triggered on the next bar. So the answer is no, we were not, right? So here, now what happens is if we have seen this, normally we should change our buy stop to this bar. But we cannot do this. Why? Because now the candle is no more good. It's like an inside bar. So inside bar meaning that it's contained within the previous bar. So all this candle is inside the previous bar, okay? So we cannot take this trade. Of course it triggers, okay? And if it triggers, we would have lost because it would have hit our stop loss. But again, we wouldn't have entered this trade because this bar is an inside bar, okay? So let's try to move forward again. So whatever happens after the second retrace, as I say, you are too late to the party. So we cannot look at any trade opportunities over here. All right. So now it's starting to go on a downward, the slope is going downward. We have an impulse move to the downside, so we are going to try to see if it retraces to the 21 EMA. It does, but we cannot take this trade. Why? Because the candlestick is not what we need, right? It's fairly bullish. It closed on its top 25%, and we don't want this when we want to sell. Okay, when we want to short, we want it to close on its bottom 25%, and if possible, the candle to be red. Okay, so we cannot take this trade. What about the next one? Also, you will see some other trades that I mark on the chart. So this is not part of the strategy of the part one of the course, but we will learn how we would have taken this trade on the part two or on the part three. So if it doesn't have a red rectangle, just don't look at it right for the moment. Okay, so here it's pretty much choppy, right? So same here it's where you need to stay out of the market, because the EMA is pretty flat, right? And you can see the price is like really congested on the same area, so you don't want to trade on this type of stuff. Okay, so now it starts to angle up again, so I'm always going further, but so it starts to open up again. Your candlestick is not very good, right? Because, so first, even before looking at the candlestick, it doesn't retrace to the 21 EMA. So we should just keep it, right? Let's not even talk about it, because it doesn't retrace to the 21. Another impulsive move. Okay, so it retraced to the 21. Here we can put our buy stop above this candle. Does it trigger on the next one? No, it doesn't trigger, but on this candle, it's even better than this one. Why? Because this candle is like a hammer. It closed on its top 25%, so it's a very good candlestick to basically put our trade, right? So what we want to do is to put a buy stop and wait for the trigger to basically happen, okay? So here now we are inside the trade, because this bar goes above this one, one tick above. So we have bought, and now what we want to see is if we have our 2-to-1 reward to risk ratio. So for this, I'm gonna measure the length of this candle. And what we want, right, is for the price to at least reach this level. If it doesn't reach this level, right, then we are not winner. We will only take profit if it reaches this level, right? So let's check it out. Okay, so as you see, we are hit. That means that in this candle, we have made like a profit of 2 by taking a risk of 1. Okay, so this is a very good trade, and we have 1 winner for the day. Let's continue. All right, so after this secondary trace, we cannot look at any long over here, because as I said, you are already too late to the party. We can only take the first or the second retrace. Past that, we cannot take any trade. Okay, so we need to wait and look for other opportunities. So again, this is like fairly advanced trade that is not part of the course number one. Okay, so I went too further too much. So here, right, we start to have an impulsive move to the downside, and we can see that the slope is starting to go down, right? So we are starting to have like a reverse of the trend. So what we want to do is to find if the price is bouncing out of the EMA. So it did on this candle, but this candle is not good to enter, right? And here it does it again. And it does it on a very good candle. So it's the reverse of the previous situation, right? Where basically we want to sell and we have a good candle, because this candle is like an inverted hammer, and it closed on its bottom 25%. So we want to enter this trade, put a sell stop over here, and then look at if it triggers. So it triggers over here, right? So what we want to do now is to compute our risk to reward ratio, right? So as I said, what we want to do is to take two rewards for one risk. Okay, so we for this, we compute this. Okay. And we check if the price is hitting this level or not. Right? So it does. So barely, right? We can see that it touches it over here. We would have won, but it was quite tough because we won at one tick, right? So yeah, again a second trade, so we are 2-0 for the day, right? Then we have another retrace, so impulse retrace. This you cannot take it because the candle is basically shit, right? So it's the type of candle that I was talking about that is like a doji. It has like zero body. There is no body on this candle, so you don't want to take this. Okay. Past the secondary trace, we cannot look at anything, right? Because you will be too late to the party. So here we can see the market move forward. Okay. Yeah. It's flat, so we cannot trade. The market starts to move upwards. So what would have happened? So you have an impulsive move, it retrace, it doesn't retrace to the 21, so we cannot take this move. Okay. So we are waiting for other opportunities. It goes up, 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 retrace, but doesn't retrace to the 21, so we cannot take this opportunity. Right. Again, now we have like first retrace, second retrace. We cannot consider any long anymore. Okay, so the market goes up again. Then the EMA goes pretty flat. So the price is doing like random. We cannot do anything. Okay, and that's it. So at 2 a.m. is the time at which the market closes. So I will also wrap up this video. But what I wanted to show you is that whenever you start your day, right, you kind of need to have a checklist, right? So today we had like two winners, so only two trades, which is actually pretty good because having 2 days, for 2 trades on a day, it's like massive. And then if in the future you have 2 trades per day every day, you will really be happy, and it was really good trades, right? Most of the time, as I said, you will have like 0 trades. And you will have to wait a lot. Now, I just want to also re-explain the checklist that I take a look at. So the number one thing is that I look at if the trend is going up or down, thanks to the SMA. Number two, I look at when there is a retrace. Does it retrace to the 21? If it doesn't, I don't even look at it. Number three, I look at the candlestick. So if the candlestick is good and is doing a pivot low or pivot high, so swing high or swing low, right? And if it closes on its top 35%, then I will enter the trade. And then when I enter the trade, what I want to take a look at is that we have risk and reward. So risk one to win two, right? So for this, I will measure the size of the candle, which will be my risk, and then I want to go 2 times for my reward of the size of the candle. Okay, 4 is past the second retrace. I will not look at any opportunities anymore on the direction of the trend. Okay, so that's it. I'll cut the video over here. I will give more examples on some following videos.